Betsy here. Welcome back to another episode of DIY with Joy. Today I will be teaching you how to make this really cool LED light up mason jar. I love it so much. This is great for parties. This is great for any decoration inside and outside of the home. And best of all, it's super easy to recreate. So it's pretty much what I like to call it, a party in a jar. It's a mason jar, there's glass embellishments, there's rainbow strobe lights inside of here, and it's super affordable to make. I got most of my supplies from the dollar store. Everything is easily accessible. You don't have to go to any type of crazy store to buy some special thing. You can definitely do this by yourself or you can do it with a group. These are great sort of party favors. These are great centerpieces for tables if you wanted something more futuristic and different. And it definitely catches a lot of eyes. Like, this looks so cool. I bet you weren't even paying attention to anything that I was saying and just looking at this. So if you're interested in how to make this party LED light up mason jar, please keep on watching.
What you will need, a mason jar. I decided to get a 16 ounce, but feel free to use whatever size you like. I got it from the dollar store. Then you will need glass accent gems, and those are the glass marbles which are flat on one side. And I also got it from the dollar store, and I got two different sizes, one large and one medium. Then you will need a hot glue gun. You would also need a LED light up bracelet. You don't have to get the exact same one. I also got this from the dollar store, but if you can't find it, Christmas lights will also work as well. Lastly, you will need Easy Sand, which is pretty much lightweight drywall plaster. This is the one that dries in 5 minutes. This is from Home Depot. If you don't want to get this, you can also use modeling clay. To start off the tutorial, you want to go ahead and take your glass gems and start applying it onto the mason jar. The beauty about this DIY is you can pretty much do it however you want to. So we got two different sizes of these round glass gems, so we decided to put it alternatively. But like I said, you can do whatever you want. Just go ahead and apply a good amount of hot glue and start sticking it onto the mason jar. This will take a little bit of time, but trust me, once everything's in place, this is pretty much the hardest part of the tutorial right here. You want to make sure when you're hot gluing the accent gems onto the mason jar, you leave a little bit of space in between because we will be filling in those spaces with plaster later. And when you're done, it should look something like this. Look how awesome it looks. Now for the fun and slightly messy part. So you want to take some plaster, pour it in a plastic cup or a cup that you don't really care too much about. Add some water into it. Make sure the consistency is like cake, if you know what I mean. And then start applying the plaster onto the mason jar. It's going to be a little bit sloppy. Just make sure you're in an area where you really don't care about. And plaster, when it dries, it's easily to come off anyway, so it really doesn't matter. But when you're applying the plaster onto the mason jar, make sure you get in between all of those crevices. And it's okay if you apply plaster onto the accent gem itself, because we will be wiping that off later. Alright, and just a little reminder, just make sure when you're applying the plaster, you apply a thick coat. And when I mean thick, I mean really thick. You know what I mean? Just make sure you cover all the gems. Don't worry if it looks messy, because we will go ahead and fix that later on and it's going to look amazing. So just remember, the more the better. Wait about 5 minutes for the plaster to set and we will go ahead and go on to the next step. Now, after you waited about 5 to maybe even 10 minutes for the plaster to set, you're going to take a wet, in this case we use a microfiber towel, to gently start removing the excess plaster. Make sure you are super careful with this step. You don't want to rub too hard or else the plaster will crack and break and everything that you've done will just be destroyed. So just make sure you do gentle strokes onto the plaster. Ew, that sounded so disgusting. However, once you do that, you will start seeing the gems come out. And then if you want to, go ahead and take a dishwashing sponge and go ahead and rub that all over the plaster to smooth out all of the edges and to make the entire thing shine. Like, it looks amazing and great, and I love it so much. Remember the light up LED bracelet from the beginning of the video? Yeah, we will go ahead and work on that now. So the cool thing about LED lights is that little thing right there on the left hand side is the actual LED light and the rest of the bracelet is plastic. So go ahead and detach that. Then we will go ahead and put it in the oven. Yep, you heard it right. Don't worry, we're not gonna put it in the oven for too long, only about 2 minutes until the plastic melts. Then we're going to take it out. We're going to roll it into a straight line, so when you apply the LED lights, it will be a nice even flow. Quickly attach the LED light back onto the bracelet and it should look something like this. Awesome, I love it. Now for size, because we straighten out the bracelet, it's going to be a little bit taller than the mason jar, so just attach it, measure it a little bit, kind of guesstimate where you need to cut it. Use a kitchen knife to kind of score on the edges and then bend it to break it free. Then you want to apply it back into the mason jar and it should look something like this. I love the finish, I love the layout, it looks absolutely perfect. Then go ahead and take some hot glue, apply it to the tip of the bracelet, and attach the LED light to the plastic part of the bracelet. Or, well, it's not a bracelet anymore, the plastic piece. Then apply hot glue again onto the opening of the mason jar and apply your LED light so it can stay in place. And that is pretty much it. Turn on your light, apply your lid, turn off the lights, and let the party begin.
Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed making this LED light up mason jar with me. If you plan to recreate this mason jar, please send me a photo. Use the hashtag DIYWithJoy and I would love to repost your photos onto my blog. You guys have sent me pictures before and I absolutely love it. And I would love to eventually create a little gallery for you guys, so I can post all of your pictures and then link maybe your own YouTube video or your own blog as well. And I think that would be great to kind of network in that type of sense. But if you are new to my channel, hi, my name is Vanessa. I do a lot of DIY, fashion, beauty, and travel videos here on my channel. Please subscribe, join the family. I promise you won't regret it. If you enjoy this video, please give this video a thumbs up. And I will go ahead and see you in the next video. Bye!